self-described doo-wop folk rock duo Stabwounds have stunning voices that are as piercing as serrated knives and incredibly enticing harmonies that soften out all that edginess. Think new millennial Joni Mitchells, all fresh and new and fierce, and you get a front row seat to their ferocity on this astonishing episode of B-Side. I'm your host, Melanie Charles, and I hope you're ready to ride right here, right now, on B-Side. Let's go! For the people who don't know, you are Emma.
That's correct.
You're Amanda.
That's correct.
And that's Aaron back there.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Three for three.
All present. Good. So Stabwounds, that's like a really like whimsical name. Are you guys causing the Stabwounds or receiving them or both?
A bit of both, probably. Yeah.
Column A, yeah. Column B.
Yeah. Yeah. Check A and B.
Yeah. Yeah. How did you guys meet? Like, how did this happen?
We got put in a reading together at a theater company that we both were kind of working in, and they needed music for it. And Emma had some songs that she taught me, and I like played in this show. And a couple weeks later, I got an email from her, like a blast email that was like, "Hey, like I'm playing with my band at..."
Which I had invented. There was no band.
Okay.
The email was like, "We have our first show this date. was like a month later, and I emailed her back and I said, "How dare you start a band without me?" And she was like, "Come to the rehearsal." And then I came, and then that was it.
But wait, the band was just the two of you guys.
She was singing with her roommate at the time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, so the band has changed a little bit from the beginning.
Now we have Aaron.
Now there's Aaron.
Yeah.
So, like, how long has this been? Would you say a year, 2 years now?
With Aaron?
With Aaron.
Well, with you guys, too.
Oh.
You two.
2 years with this, with this format. Yeah.
And then with Aaron is...
I mean, like, 6 months ago?
Yeah.
Nice.
Or more? I don't know.
I think 8 months. June was our first show together.
Oh, happy almost anniversary.
Oh, nice. Congrats. You sound like really tight, like you play a lot. I know you guys were just on tour in March, right?
Yeah.
How was that?
Good, a lot of couch sleeping. Mm-hmm. So, you know, good. Yeah, it's always interesting to get on the road with people. We had someone tell us once, like, hey, go on the road and then see if you still like each other.
Yeah, if it works on the road, it'll work.
Yep.
Right. Where did you guys go?
Northampton and a bunch of Maine. We saw a lot of Maine.
Okay.
In New Hampshire, yeah.
Maine is nice.
Oh my God, did I say Northampton?
Yeah, it's okay.
It's not even remotely true.
You,
you want to go to Northampton?
No, we do, but Northampton and New Hampshire have this a lot of the same letters.
Yeah, that's true.
don't make excuses for me. That's absurd. I'm glad that the record got corrected in real time.
Right. Good. Yeah. See, you guys are such an amazing unit. Like, it always works out.
Seamless.
Yeah. So you guys play a lot in Brooklyn?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why don't we play a fair amount?
I think we actually play
city.
Yeah, in the city. So many of these Brooklyn venues are just getting
a lot of places. The first place we ever played was Goodbye Blue Monday.
They changed now, it's no longer there.
Yeah,
exactly.
Goodbye. Yeah, it's Goodbye. That's really sad. That made me cry when
we
I saw
love that
it.
Place.
Yeah.
Cameo
Gallery
Glasslands.
Yeah. RIP to all those really beautiful places. Yeah.
Well, it's ironic that your last name is Brooklyn, though. Like,
yeah, coincidental, weird. Probably like more so, but yeah, yeah.
Let the record show truly her last name.
I was gonna ask you, is that like a real
thing?
Yeah,
real thing. Like, if I changed it and then moved to Brooklyn, then I guess it would be irony. But yeah. I was born with it and like had never been to Brooklyn. My parents had never been to Brooklyn. My grandparents had never been to Brooklyn. It was Bricklin in Russia, and then okay. Ellis Island. They were like, no.
Right, we have that.
We have Bricklin. That's correct. So yeah, but it's it's fun sometimes.
Yeah. So on your Facebook page, it says you guys are influenced by Garfunkel.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty.
And Simon.
And Simon.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Yeah,
together.
Not just art. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Who else would you guys say you're influenced by?
The White Stripes,
mm-hmm.
All the rock minimalism.
Mm-hmm.
Joni,
yeah,
of course.
Joni for sure.
How could you not love Joni?
Jenny Lewis is a very big hero.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I grew up on like the Beatles and the Stones. I know Em, you grew up on like.
I certainly heard them.
You'd heard of them, yeah. But your dad loves.
Well, my dad loves the Dead, but I wouldn't say that we have that much to do with them.
No.
Although he lobbied very hard for an Uncle John's Band cover. Ago.
Are you going to do that today?
No.
Damn, Dad would be so happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Next time.
Maybe a private show for Dad.
Yes.
Yeah, but would it have to be like 8 minutes long? Like we need a jam.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I want to be there.
Okay. You
and my
Papa
dad.
Bish.
Yes. All right, so that first song was called Eastern Standard Time.
Yep.
I like that title a lot. I think we're ready for the next one.
Great.
Cool.
Yeah.
So what's this next one called?
It's called Shakespeare, and it's named for the person who wrote all the lyrics.
Okay. Shout out to Shakespeare.
What up, Will?
Excels each mortal thing upon the dull earth dwelling. I have no other than a woman's reason. think him so because I think him so. I think him so because I think him so. I think him so because I think him so. For long for his passion lives. He after on her hunts, I after love. I leave myself, my friends, and all for love. Kind to you, unkind. What thinkest thou of rich Mercati? Oh, I think him so,
I think him so.
I think him so because I think him so. Thou damn'st it up, the more it burns. Neglect my studies, lose my time. Record my woe, the inly touch of love. Record my woe, the naked lame of love. Folded hood and hood. Thinkest thou of rich Mercati? Oh, I think him so. I think him so because I think him so.
About this song. So Shakespeare, like, that's obviously like some old school-ish right there.
Yeah.
Would you guys consider yourselves old souls?
Yeah.
At all?
Yeah. Like, not definitely. Not to, like, you know, boost myself up, but like, yeah.
Hey, it is what it is. And so, like, what genre would you guys describe this? I know, like, as artists, you know, it's kind of annoying to have to put yourselves in a box, but if you had to,
I just, like, hope someone else will put us in a box for us. I'm like, I don't want to wrap it up. I want someone else to be like, this is what you are.
I mean, like, and in an ideal world, people just listen to it instead of read the four words that describe our approximated genre. But our approximated genre
we call it
doo-wop inspired folk rock.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's pretty spot on.
But folk rock is evocative, I think, of a different thing that is not really what we are, even though there's folk and rock.
Yeah.
Involved.
Yeah. Emma once said I think you said it was folk music through a rock music gramophone, which I thought was really cool.
Yeah.
You said that long ago. I wrote
it down.
Don't
remember it.
Yep, I have it written in a Word document.
Yes.
Emma said, good thing today.
Probably a pretty short Word document.
Yeah, it is. It's really short. One sentence. That's my journal. I just have like 150 like very short Word documents. Kidding.
So you said gramophone, so now it reminds me that you guys are working on your album, your debut EP, right?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Woo!
Yeah. Coming out in spring, right?
Yes. Soon.
So is it gonna be like lo-fi-ish? Like,
it's a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B. Yeah. We kinda wanted to see, you know, we wanted people to see what we hear, mm-hmm. which is, I think, you know, along a vast spectrum.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of really, really stripped down, and there's some that's stripped up than we've ever played live before.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that would be like winter clothes, I guess. Stripped up.
Winter clothes. Zipped up, full snowsuit. Yeah.
Yes, onesie and all.
Yeah.
And you guys are pretty stripped down, you know, technically speaking, with just the drums and two voices and guitar. But you don't miss anything. Like, it's still grooving. It's still, like, vibes.
That's very good to know. Thank you.
Yeah, seriously. You guys are both very beautiful ladies.
Well, this is just compliments.
How are we doing here at B-Side? So, do you ever feel like that's an issue, like sexism, is, you know, being women in this whole industry?
Yeah, sexism is alive and well in the industry.
Yep. Doing kicking. Yep.
Yeah. I feel like the worst that ever felt was that show. We went to this, we played the show at Glasslands, and I don't know if you remember this, we were like 3 hours early, and we were wearing some matching outfits that were probably on the girlier
side. We were wearing corsets and like,
and they didn't want to let us in. Like, they were like,
I don't remember this.
I do. We got there like when they were opening.
Yeah.
And we were like, we're in the band. And they were like, I don't think that's right.
Right.
What? Yeah.
We've had a lot of just like we show up to venues and they're we showed up once early and like someone else came looking for us and they were like, oh, you mean the teens wearing matching dresses?
Yes.
So like you just get a lot of kickback when you are like small and like cutish, you know.
Yeah.
So we try not. That's like where the name kind of stemmed from. Is that like
we wanted to kind of cut that off at the quick.
Yeah, I feel that.
Or at least juxtapose it, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, it's interesting. Like even the way you guys dress, it's very like, you know, demure and classy, but the people don't know that in sound check you had to cut some songs out because some of the language. But I think it's cool because it's sort of like you're making a statement that your music isn't necessarily for everyone, right? There's sort of like an exclusivity to it. Is that purposeful or?
I think we want, like, we would love everyone to love it and appreciate it. I think that's like a pipe dream that like no one can, you know, you can't make music for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're just kind of, it's just what's, oh, it's, I keep hearing what I'm gonna say, and I'm like, you can't say that.
Say it.
It's just we're doing what's true. Like that, and like this was the way to each song. I think expresses the idea it was trying to express. It just so happens that some of them use curse words, and yeah. I think that makes it, you know, PG-13R. But you know, we're moving ahead
in
the world.
These labels and categories.
Everybody knows the F bomb.
Yeah, it's honest.
Yeah,
I feel that.
But we certainly, I don't think we set out to be like, our band's gonna be exclusive.
Right. I actually remember I had one of our earlier shows, my boyfriend at the time came to the show, and something, I will never forget it. It was just like, felt so offensive. He was like, yeah, you guys were like pretty good. Like, seems like you really have a niche audience of like young women living in Brooklyn. And I feel like those are the kind of people who really like your music. I'm like, that's great. Like, I'm a young woman living in Brooklyn, but for you to put us in that category is garbage.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
College boyfriend, you know. Get out of here.
He's young, poor kid. But I mean, there is a little bit of, you know, as artists, we do have to sort. It's good to know your demographic.
Exactly.
Right?
For sure.
So maybe like the way he said it was kind of annoying, but I kind of get what he's saying. Like, it's
totally
good to know that there's a strong community here in Brooklyn that will like go to your shows and like
buy
your wonderful artwork, your t-shirts. You guys make your own.
Amanda doesn't.
Shout out to Amanda. Merch.
Yeah. I for those of you who don't know, I hand embroider our t-shirts with song lyrics. Like really, really feminine of me to do, but really cathartic for anyone. I don't know if anyone here does needlework, needlepoint, but it's just like the best thing in the world. If you don't do it, you should do it.
Yeah.
Better than Headspace app. Actually, I don't know. I've never done Headspace, but like very meditative.
Yeah, you guys should get some. I want a t-shirt, so we'll talk business later.
All right, we'll talk later. Yeah.
You listen for a lyric, and you can request one.
Okay, if people have.
Yeah, ooh. I always hope people will, and you know, some people do, and sometimes I do it.
All right. Well, the next song you guys are doing is Rosalind, right?
Rosalind.
Very close. Damn it.
It's okay. I didn't write it out phonetically.
Oh, man. Well, what's Rosalind about?
Rosalind is about...
Rosalind.
I think Rosalind speaks for itself.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah, it's... I don't really even...
It's about... it just happens to be a Shakespeare reference next to the song called Shakespeare. I'm a huge fan. Who am I kidding? But Rosalind is this character in Romeo and Juliet. I don't think you ever meet her, but she's the woman that Romeo loved. you're nodding so hard. She's the woman that Romeo really, really loved and is completely heartbroken over at the beginning of the play before he even meets Juliet. Mm. And I was sort of thinking about her and like sort of like the disturbing nature of young love where we're so obsessively interested in someone and then we're so obsessively interested in someone else. Mm-hmm. And like the relationship between, you're like, yes.
I feel that.
Definitely something you think about in this age.
Yeah.
So it's yeah, about that kind of experience.
All right,
and about the Rosalines
yeah.
of the world.
Shout out.
Let's hear it.
Okay.
She's butter to you. You and a warm woman movable. And you're liquor to her. You sip sweet, but you burn on the way down. Watching the room, watching me. She knows you like what they say. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry for all that you give. Sorry for all that you give to me. You parse us out like a sieve. That isn't love or letting live, don't you agree? On your rainy day, I'm cold, but I'm worth a walk. And your summer in May, too hot to stay.
And beautiful. People might say that you guys sort of have like a country influence. Would you agree with that? Do you guys like country music?
Not a country influence. People have told us that we have like, a couple people have said like we have a country vibe. What I always say is that country music are just like the
plaintive singing.
Well, just like the singers who like maybe were too good to be rock and roll singers. Like, that just have, like, the craziest vocal prowess. And, like, rock music just, like, didn't appreciate it enough. You know, like you listen to those women and like they are all over the place. It's really remarkable.
It's true.
But like I didn't listen to country music growing up. I was like one of those girls in high school who was like, don't put on country. You
know? I think it's like the emotional quality. Like, I mean, yeah. Patsy Cline kind of.
Oh, for sure.
You know? Yeah. She's not country, but like she's.
Well,
country.
Like, was Dolly country technically?
Yeah. I would say.
I mean, so yeah. Like, yeah.
But I guess, you know, it's just women with unbelievable ranges and like. Effortless emoting.
Yeah, and also the stories too. Like country music is like the stories that they tell in the songs. Are,
really
and you
true.
Guys are obviously wonderful storytellers. How do you write your songs? Like lyrics first, chords first?
I find that I pretty much always have to do them at the same time or it doesn't feel honest. Like I just sort of have to like, you know, it's like both feet at the same time, every step. Yeah, and then once like the beginning, like once each A or each B exists, then I can kind of like plop the lyrics in. Yeah, but it's just gotta be the same at the same time.
And so it sounds like you do most of the writing, would
I
you
write
say?
The music, yeah.
Okay, so that's interesting because it's not, it doesn't come across as just like, oh, this is my music, it's my thing.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like you both are really connected to the music in an honest way. That's really awesome.
Yeah, I mean, like, she's the writer, but like it's our music, I think.
Yeah, it's we also like, I mean, there's kind of a philosophy behind, we talked about this a little to Marion once about, right? Do you remember what I'm talking about?
I touched it.
What did you touch?
I touched the mic.
It's okay.
Excuse me.
Oh my God.
About how part of what's so important is that I feel like as women and also as people, we feel like we're supposed to be boxed in. You know, we're supposed to be one thing and you're supposed to cultivate some kind of really stable identity. And I think that the anxiety that we both experience in our 20s is a lot about that not being valid. Mm. And I think presenting these like single subject I songs
as two
helps
people.
Us to really emphasize how wonderfully contradictory we are allowed to be.
Yeah. I mean, I think we're ready for some more. This next song, I think it's, oh, it's David Lynch is next, right?
Yeah.
Mm. Okay, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Actually, we doing I was okay gonna talk on time?
About, yeah, we're doing good.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
David Lynch is so much less personal sounding than what I just said.
layers. Emma and I, when we first were really hanging out, I just finished Twin Peaks and she just started it, right?
No, you made me.
I made her watch it, and then
Amanda,
halfway through it, ruined it.
Came over for a sleepover, and you were like, "We gotta watch the first episode of Twin Peaks. We have to watch it. I really want to watch it." You fell asleep in two minutes.
Yeah. Classic.
It's 2 hours. And I sat up in her apartment, watched the whole thing, and then was like, "Amanda, wake up! I'm so scared." Yeah.
The song came out of that fear.
I've seen you a good bit. Now still it's taken us days to get liquored up like this. But I needed you to. Your sober mouth is painfully plain and nonchalant. To tell me now, am I exactly what you want? Or am I? I could swallow you tonight. Life is a dream with you, sweetheart. Life is a dream, a dream is a steam with you. What a gas with you. I heard you singing, soft like an eloquent animal. And I wanted you so damn bad, so terribly badly. Your sour mouth is engine red. Oh, what wouldn't I give To not owe you south is to know dearly well that I've lived. So can we lay down tonight? My body is yours to blight. Pretty please swallow me tonight. Another sweet soda, please. Life is a dream. Life is a dream with you, sweet heart.
Yeah. Yeah. So, has anyone ever said that you guys sound too sweet for the grit of New York? Has anyone ever said anything like that?
No.
No.
Good.
No.
Yeah.
I think once people talk to us, we don't even get that anymore. Yeah.
Also, I think that, like, New York needs as much sweet as it can get, you know? Mm. Also, Emma grew up in New York. Like, she's got the grit.
Yeah.
You know?
You got the grit.
You got the grit.
Thanks.
You got the grit.
You all got the grit.
Whatever that means. Three fingers. So.
Yeah. Three fingers.
I'm going to start something new here.
This is a stab gesture, everybody.
We're gonna. I think we want to go to the next song.
Okay.
Okay.
This one is the one that.
This one is so heart wrenching. I love this. I watched the video, and that was like in your room, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Now the whole world will see your room.
Well, she moved.
It's actually my old room. But I like that room a lot.
It was pretty.
I loved it.
I wonder who lives there now.
Maybe a fragile boy.
Probably.
I'd say odds are 50-50
everywhere.
On that. Come on, Snark. No, not yet.
We can
no.
chat a little bit.
Please.
So what pop singers right now or more modern singers you like? Because we talked about the old school stuff.
Yeah.
Joni, Simon, Garfunkel. Who is like going, who's cool right now that you're like, I like that?
I was like
Courtney Barnett.
Yeah. We love Lucius.
Lucius.
I love Chromeo, but like that's not like an influence, you know?
Kendrick. Not an influence. Kendrick's an influence in its own way.
It doesn't have to be an influence. It could be just people
music
that you like.
We like.
Yeah,
yeah. Who do I like?
Father John Misty.
Like. Oh, my favorite band right now is probably Escort. I don't know if any of you know Escort.
I don't write that down.
You gotta write that down.
Yeah, I'm writing that
they
down
are,
now.
They are. It's like a 12-piece like disco funk band, and the lead singer is just like. So killer. They're really great. I mean, like a very different vibe, but really, if you like to dance, it's like there's like I feel like it's hard to find live music these days that you can like really just go and dance the whole time. And you can she does it. They do it.
Yes, so, that's cool. Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Good to
just
know.
Plugged the heck out of Escort.
But we're talking about Stabwounds today, though. So let's get back.
All right, we back. Can't dance to this one.
Maybe really slow.
Yeah, this way.
He's a fragile boy. Busted all his toys and calling me late in the night. 'Cause he can't stand the fright. Oh, should I wait till he's right for me? But I doubt he'd dare to call me then. Only wants me for lonesome friends. Till he's lovely, if he loves me, I guess. Don't make decent jokes. Afraid if he laughs, he'll choke. He's begging me, stop with the smiles, lady. Stay for a while. Oh, should I break out your file? But those pages have been long perused. licked and turned, so swift and near abused. Still they're lovely if he loves them, I guess. Maybe try to weather this fall without me, without me. I miss your ma and your pooch and your pa, but they doubt me and they should doubt me. 'Cause I'm not for you like you wanted me to be. What's love at first can melt or burst into weeds. But when you find her, may she be pretty like the Linwood tree where you kissed me. Good night. I pray you mind her if she seems
a little less complicated than me, 'cause
maybe that means she's the one to keep. A picture I'll confide, that blue whale in low tide, or was that your dream, not mine? Am I wasting your time, or should I show you these lines?
But I know you'll never hear them right. No, you won't taste the hate, won't touch the spite. 'Cause I'm lovely, 'cause you love me, I guess.
Maybe try to weather this fall without me, without me. I miss your ma and your pooch and your pa, but they doubt me and they should doubt me.
'Cause I'm
not for you like you wanted me to be. What's love at first can melt or burst into weeds. But when you find her, may she be pretty like the Linwood tree where I kissed you.
Hello.
I pray you mind her if she seems
a little less complicated than me,
'cause maybe that means she's the one you
wanna run to.
Give her sons who
wanna do the things that she likes to.
Marry her, John. Marry her, John. And if I'm too far gone by then, I'll say
she's lovely
'cause you love her.
Can we talk some more about this song?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
It's my fave. Mm-hmm. So is this based on a true story? What is this John reference?
Oh, no comment. Or comment.
No, please.
Do you want me to talk about
no,
it?
No.
Okay, you're just looking at me. Hey, babe.
I guess I'm just looking for
help.
I don't know. It's this, pretty. It's like of the things, it's probably the most literal. It's pretty old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it like a prostitute and her John?
Boy, wow.
Woo, that's literal.
I kind of love that.
Yeah, that's what it's about.
Okay.
The nail on the head. You got it, girl.
And I don't know, to me, I hear like a lot of Joni vibes in that one. Would you agree?
Yeah.
I'd love to agree.
That's
yeah.
kind. We appreciate that.
So yeah. Like when you say the word pretty and then you guys do that like dissonant like two note thing, it was just like perfect. The lyrics and the notes like go hand in hand with that one really beautifully.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So you guys are indie, right?
We're independent yeah.
artists too. So yeah. I totally feel you guys. Do you like being independent? Do you want to stay independent? Do you want to get signed to a label? What's the vibe?
I think pretty much again, I'm hearing it and it sounds so cliche, but it's just true, is all we really want is to be able to make good art that people hear. And so it's not really about like, oh, we're really shooting. I mean, obviously there are labels we really like that make music we like, but we're not really shooting to get signed more than we're shooting for like more opportunities that let us be self-sustaining artists and not like kiddie music teachers.
Right, and bartenders, yeah.
Yeah.
So like if signing with a label means that like we get to keep doing it, great. If staying independent means you get to keep doing it, then that. But like, I also like, for me, like, I don't even know what it means. Like, I wouldn't know what it means to be signed to a label. Like, independent is all I know. So, like, maybe it would be amazing and maybe it would be terrible. Like, I think that, you know, the ideal for most musicians, like, if you're, you know, if you dream of being a musician, it's getting a record deal, being signed to Sony, you know, blah, blah, blah. But, like, what does that mean other than, you know, a big paycheck? So, like, I personally, like, don't really have thoughts on it either way because I don't have, like, the experience to really back it up, you know?
Would you say, like, the change in the industry has influenced you feeling that way? Do you think if maybe we had this interview, like, 15, 20 years ago, maybe it'd be a different thing?
Yeah, I mean, I think we probably, there wouldn't be that many other ways to, there wouldn't be any other way to go.
Right.
We would be playing in a club, right? Or we would be signed to a label.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, you guys have done a lot of work in the independent music world, like So Far Sounds. I love them.
Yeah, Yay. So Far is great. Yeah, right.
You know, those things are come along with the change in this music biz. And Aaron back there, what do you feel like you balance these ladies out being the man in the band?
I wouldn't say that. I don't even really know what you mean. Balance what out?
Well, okay. How did you decide that Aaron was the drummer for this band? Like, what was it about him that you're like, okay?
It was awesome, actually. Aaron and I met because he is an amazing songwriter and guitarist, and obviously an amazing singer. But I had no idea he could play the drums, and I was singing backup for this other band at So Far Sounds a long time ago, and his band that he writes beautiful music for was playing. And I really liked his music, and I had no reason to believe that he would like my music because all he'd heard me do was like, bop, 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 like you do when you're singing
with the Beach Boys.
Yeah. It was the Beach Boys that I was playing So Far with. and we really liked Isadora, and you knew who Isadora was, and we booked a gig with them. And then after he saw us play, he was like, I would really love to play the drums for you.
Volunteered.
And we were like, what? You want to play the what? Because we've never seen him do it.
Like, Amy Blue Eyes wants to play
with
us?
They were just so nice to me after my set. And I was like, I was in a weird headspace that night. Just to say that.
Oh, right, at Arlene.
Yeah, so I was just kind of like really blown away by these two girls coming up to me to say what they had to say. Mm. And yeah, I grew up playing drums and like kind of put it down for a while. And I noticed that it was just the two of them, and I was just thinking, like, y'all could really, like, use a band or at least, like, a drummer, so.
And it was pretty, like, I feel like the first time we rehearsed with Aaron, we kind of knew that he just, it's really amazing. There are lots of musicians that you like, but you don't get each other. But he just, like, I really feel like he gets it. It's really a gift.
Yeah.
I still remember, I think in David Lynch, when it breaks into the chorus and it's, like, the big crash cymbal. I remember when I like first did that, and you guys were both like looking at me, and at the first time that ever happened, and they like just like lost it. They're so giddy. So that's when I was like, this is gonna be fun.
Yeah.
And yeah, it has been.
That's really special when that happens, when it just clicks like that. So it's three. It's when you guys do your live shows. It's three now. Do you think you're gonna expand as you become more famous, or you want to keep it to this texture? Because I think this texture is beautiful, but do you guys have any visions of anything larger?
I think, yeah, like, you know.
I think we'll play around as long as we get away with it.
Yeah, as long as it's like, it's, you know, it still like feels like us and sounds like us and like people are still digging it, whatever. Like, we'll, you know, if we get a great bassist who we vibe well with,
that'll
we get
be cool.
a great, you know, any of that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. Probably not a 12-piece funk band, but
probably not. Girl from Dream,
you know? All right, I think we're ready for our next song, Anniversary.
Ah, yes.
Yes.
Really.
Really, really. I'm really, really, yeah.
We're just remembering, I'm reminding myself of a rewrite that we hastily made before we came on.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, really, really.
Really, I am.
Be nice to yourself, 'cause I won't do it for you, and I won't do it for you. La la la, Lord knows I don't make an easy lover. Your brother bakes, hey man, why do you love her? We wanna know, we wanna know, what's in it for you, when I abhor you. La 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 la. But I was lying when I took time to recover.
Just discovered
I'm not in love, no, not in love. And I'm really sorry, I'm really sorry.
Don't be annoyed at me like you were with your ex-boyfriend, but I would say I heard a little like beauty school dropout grief.
Oh my gosh, are you kidding? It's
meets Hair the musical.
I love it.
Definitely.
I love it.
You guys are actors too, right? That's what you mentioned.
Yeah.
Before.
One, once upon a time, we wouldn't admit this often, but those musicals influenced us.
Definitely. Oh, yeah. Grease is like my favorite, like one of my favorite things in the world.
We used to watch before we would go out.
I still watch it before I go out. That's like my pregame.
The opening
is Grease.
Yeah. I totally get you guys. I totally get it.
We wrote a song that we're not playing, tonight that one of the lyrics is Teenage Ne'er-Do-Well that she like put in there like for me. So thank you.
Did you guys see Grease live?
I watched the whole
thing. Did you approve? Was it good?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very amazing.
Yeah. Who's Sandy? Who's Rizzo?
I like the way Sandy dresses more, but
I'm Frenchie.
Are you Frenchie?
Are you?
Yeah, you're so Frenchie.
I'm Frenchie.
And I think I'm Marty. Like honestly, I think you just
really.
Yeah.
Who's Aaron?
Also Marty.
That's funny.
Aaron's probably like duty.
I don't even remember it.
So, no, it's Vince Fontaine.
Vince Fontaine, dude. Ooh, yeah.
Yeah?
It's a compliment. They're all compliments.
That's the biggest compliment.
Cool.
Who played Vince? What's his name? Come on, you
wasn't
saw it.
Wasn't it Mario Lopez?
It's Mario Lopez, your favorite person in the world. It's my sister.
Hey, sis.
Yeah, you're Mario,
Mario Lopez.
Lopez. Yeah.
No,
striking resemblance, really.
Thanks.
So, how can people hear your music?
Google. Stabwounds, one word.
Mm-hmm. Stabwoundsmusic.com is also a website. That's our website.
And Stabwounds Music is our Instagram handle.
And Facebook.com/Stabwounds Music is our Facebook handle.
And we've never done this before, but that was the best coordinated. Chelsea.
It's me. It was my phone reminding me to eat today.
Yeah, well, that was a good
thing. So Stabwounds Music is the handle for everything. So okay. If you want to listen to us, we're on SoundCloud lightly. We're on YouTube lightly. As we said, our first like content release is going to happen in May. So like us on that stuff, and then you'll
come out
hear
in
it.
May and check you guys out.
Yeah.
What song would you guys say you're the most connected to?
I think it kind of depends.
On the show. Yeah.
In like the month.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Some days we're like, we hate this. Let's never play it again. And the next month, that's our favorite song to play.
Yeah. I think I have one that's like kind of always been the one, but we're not playing it today because it's not appropriate.
What is
appropriate.
It? It's Salty Pie?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Cool. Mine's probably this next one.
You think?
Yeah.
I think maybe.
That was awesome. Really smooth. That was smooth the way you did that. Yes.
Shall we?
Are we ready for our last
one? Are we ready for our last one? Not quite ready.
Okay.
All right. Never mind. We'll say it. We'll find another way.
Another smooth way.
Another segue.
Well, at the end of anniversary, you guys said be kind to yourself.
Be
right?
Nice to yourself. Yeah.
Be nice to yourself. We're pretty.
We're busy with each other.
We're busy with each other. And I think you guys have a lot of little inspirational little like anecdotes in there. That's like really
inspirational.
Yeah. Yes.
Be nice to yourself because no one else gonna do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Would you say that that's like a message you would want to leave your fans and followers? Is there anything that you want
to
leave them?
Everybody should be
with?
Nice to themselves.
Yeah.
But I also think that a lot of it comes with like a mean edge.
A mean edge. So
that's
like
not
maybe
intended
not.
For the listener to be hurt by.
Right. Right. We don't want to hurt our listeners. You know. We want to. You know. Hurt the people who we wrote these songs about.
Yeah. It's real. I think we have a couple more minutes. So right now, people are saying you guys are Brooklyn, a Brooklyn-based duo. Do you feel connected to that? Is it just because you live here, or what is it? What is the thing about Brooklyn?
I think it's mainly that like
we
live here, and like we, you know, we started, when we started as a band, we just like rehearsed in Emma's bedroom. You know, 3 times a week. Mm. And so, you know, like Franklin Avenue has a, you know, like
Bed-Stuy?
A dear place in our
Crown Heights.
Yeah.
Franklin goes through both.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. I mean, you just cross Eastern Parkway and, right?
Atlantic.
Get it together, man.
You can cross Eastern Parkway.
You can, but it doesn't bring you to Bed-Stuy. Yeah, I think, I mean, we both love Brooklyn. What is, say that thing that I always make you say? I'll say it. She said once, she was like, I keep having this thought in my head of, and you know sometimes you get like earworms of sentences that you just like think all the time? Mm-hmm. And I think it was, she lived and died in Brooklyn, New York?
Or something like that.
Something like.
Sounds really morbid.
But
you're still alive.
Right, but like the first sentence of like a memoir, you know?
Okay.
And then, I don't know. That's an earworm for me now.
Yeah. Sorry that I lost it when I gave it to you.
Right.
But she held on to it for you.
Thank you.
It's in a Word document.
Awesome. It's your turn now to hold on to that.
Yeah.
To live and die in Brooklyn?
Yeah. I think it's your problem now.
Can't seem to leave, so.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll die. Maybe.
Maybe.
All right.
Good.
Well. It's true that hell hath no fury like a woman scorned, but love songs without angst are, well, just not worth singing. Stabwounds brought it like the femme fatales they are, and I'm not sure whether I should be singing along or sobbing. Either way, I'm inspired by their compelling voices and can't wait to hear more. And for those of you who want to hear more B-side, that is, you can catch past episodes on our YouTube channel and follow us on our Facebook page, B-Side BK. I'm your host, Melanie Charles, and remember, spread love, it's the Brooklyn way.
You're so faithful to yourself. You never cheat yourself of something that I have made, and the compliments finding me overpaid. No, I'm too touchy about these things. I should just let you take my anger and call it yours. What's mine is yours, babe. I'm giving all of those pieces away. Then I'll have nothing left to lose and everything against you. You're too humble when you say you haven't got one mean bone. I think you're full of them. Aren't we all a bit sharp? If you took the time to pull yourself apart, you'd find
calcified cruelty, it's words so unkind.
You ditch your Hail Mary, stop raiding my mind. You've hidden all of those pieces away. Now you've got nothing left to say since everything is rosy.
Every goddamn thing's rosy.
Every rosy's rosy. Read your journal, what a sham. You hadn't written one thought that you didn't read somewhere. What is it like
to have
such tiny feelings and still want to sing?
Is it like yawning or slowly choking?
You'll never be able to say,
'cause
you've hidden all of those pieces.